السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you, my student? Welcome in Quran class. My name is Shaima Bahr. I am Quran teacher. Inshallah, I will step by step with you to learn Quran, Tajweed, and Arabic lesson. Today, inshallah, we will study together a new Tajweed lesson. The lesson today is about words, relations, ارتباط, al-kalam. Words relations means the relation between the words. You can find the relations in grammatically. Grammatically means إعرابيا, in meaning, في المعنى, linguistically and in meaning, لفظا ومعنى. Let's start with grammatically. Grammatically, like number one, preposition, جار ومجرور. Number two, subject and verb, فعل وفاعل. Number three, مبتدأ and خبر. Let's start with preposition, جار ومجرور, like أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله. Please look إلى الله. إلى جار, الله مجرور. Okay. Number two in grammatically, verb and subject. الفعل والفاعل. Like وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا. جاء is verb, الحق subject, فعل وفاعل. The word is relations. جاء الحق. Okay. Number three, مبتدأ and خبر. Like بل الله مولاكم وهو خير الناصرين. الله مولاكم. الله is مبتدأ, مولاكم is خبر. Number two, word is relations. Number two is in meaning, في المعنى. Like وقالوا قلوبنا غلف بل لعنهم الله بكفرهم فقليلا ما يؤمنون. قل بل. The word ended with غلف. The sentence ended with غلف. And the word بل, no relation between غلف and بل in pronouncing, no. Grammatically, no, but the relation between them in بل is replay for this sentence. وقالوا قلوبنا غلف. It's replay for the disbeliever saying وقالوا قلوبنا غلف. The replay is بل لعنهم الله بكفرهم فقليلا ما يؤمنون. Okay. Okay. Number three, linguistically and in meaning. لفظاً ومعنى. Like الحمد لله رب العالمين. Allah is related to what's before it, الحمد, and what's after it, العالمين. The relationship is both linguistically and in meaning. لفظاً ومعنى. The types of waqf, أنواع الوقف. There are three types of waqf. Number one, optional. Number three, number two, compare. Number three, اختباري. الوقف الاختياري، الوقف الاضطراري، الوقف الاختباري. Now, let's know the difference between the types of وقف. Number one, optional. There is either stops on a word, give a good meaning, give a meaning. There are three types of optional. تام، كافي، and حسن. Number two, compelled. وقف اضطراري. Number three, اختباري. In teaching. مقام التعليم. Let's start with complete وقف. الوقف التام. Definition of complete وقف. الوقف التام is it's a stop on a word to complete in meaning and not attach it to what follows it grammatically nor in meaning. Like قالت ربي إني ظلمت نفسي وأسلمت مع سليمان لله رب العالمين ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا أن اعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون. The word العالمين comes at the end of a complete sentence. It isn't attached to the word that follows it, neither linguistically nor in meaning. This is called a complete stop. Okay? The positions of complete وقف. مواضع الوقف التام. Number one. At the end of an ayah. Number two. At the end of surah. Number three. At the end of a story. Let's start with at the end of an ayah. نهاية الآية. Like الحمد لله رب العالمين the end of an ayah الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. Okay, at the end of surah like ولا الضالين. At the end of a story like أنجيناه وأهله إلا امرأته كانت من الغابرين أمطرنا عليهم مطرا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المجرمين وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا. المجرمين at the end of story for Prophet Hud in سورة هود. Always with the story for Prophet Shu'aib. Stopping on al-mujrimin is complete stop. Waqfatan. Okay. Now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to make, like, share, and subscribe. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.